Kestrel, IIS, IIS HTTP server and the http.sys. An ASP.NET Core application cannot directly accept requests from the internet. For this, it needs a server that can face the internet and help it communicate with the calling client on the other side. This means that some sort of coupling is required with the server software. This tutorial discusses various possibilities of coupling to a server software and then serving the requests to the remote client. One method is to run it as a self-contained application through an integrated server called Kestrel. This method doesn't require any external server such as IIS. I will come to the details of Kestrel in a moment, but standalone mode is mainly used for testing purposes because of the console window that opens alongside. It is not used in production scenarios because Kestrel is not a sophisticated server. Let me first show how to run your application in a standalone mode. When you build an ASP.NET Core application, a DLL and an .exe file are created for you. Let us open the output directory to have a look at the DLL and the executable. You can now either double-click the executable or open a command prompt and run the command .NET followed by the path to the DLL. When the application runs, it launches Kestrel automatically. A console window opens and a running log of messages also appears. It can be a convenient view for seeing exceptions and errors. We can open the browser to verify that the app responds to our requests. Now let us have a look at a brief introduction to the features of Kestrel. Kestrel is a web server software, and like every software, every server software, it can listen for HTTP requests. This is the first thing. Secondly, Kestrel is cross-platform, so it can work on Linux also. And thirdly, it is based on an open source library called LibUV. It is included and enabled by default when an ASP.NET Core app is created through the project templates, such as through Visual Studio. No special effort or steps are required for installing or configuring it. And fifthly, Kestrel has been written and adapted by Microsoft specifically for use with an ASP.NET Core web application. Now let us come to the second method, where Kestrel is behind an IIS proxy. This method is called out of process. We know that Kestrel is neither too advanced and nor is it designed for facing the internet directly. Hence, a better method could be to use Kestrel as the backend of an IIS server, that is, to use IIS as a reverse proxy for Kestrel. Hence, an ASP.NET Core application can be deployed to run with an IIS plus Kestrel combination. In this case, the IIS faces the internet and forwards requests to the Kestrel server running through your ASP.NET Core application. Requests come from the internet, then they reach IIS, which makes a loopback localhost request to Kestrel. Kestrel is running as an independent process. Then Kestrel forwards it to your application. Your application processes it and sends the response to Kestrel, which in turn sends it to IIS and then to the client. This scheme was the default and recommended scheme before version 2.2 of ASP.NET Core. The problem with this scheme is that it is slower because IIS and Kestrel run in two different processes and a time lag becomes noticeable on heavier traffic. It is not the default scheme anymore now, but it is still supported, especially if the hosting is on a Linux, Apache, Nginx. This scheme needs to be enabled through the csproj file now, because it is not the default scheme, it is not enabled anymore. For this, open the Solution Explorer, right-click the project to open the context menu, select Edit Project File and click it. The project settings open in an XML format. Add the setting ASP.NET Core Hosting Model to out of process. All the necessary port settings like environment variables, etc., ports also between IIS and Kestrel, they will be automatically made when this application is published to the internet the next time. So it is just a matter of changing ASP.NET Core Hosting Model. Let us come to the third method. The third method and the most used one is to use a module called IIS HTTP Server, which replaces the use of Kestrel altogether. This is a faster alternative to using Kestrel plus IIS. In this method, Kestrel is not used. This is now the default setting. The value ASP.NET Core Hosting Model is in process by default after ASP.NET Core 2.2. ASP.NET Core now includes a new module called IIS HTTP Server that runs in the same process as the IIS. Now it is different from the situation with Kestrel. Kestrel runs as an independent process, but IIS HTTP Server loads in the same process as of IIS. I won't be able to go into more technical details and more explanation. For more technical details, you can refer to the MSDN documentation of IIS HTTP Server. The advantage is that the application becomes faster, because there is no out-of-process communication to an external instance. The fourth method is also there. It is with http.sys. http.sys is an HTTP server based on http.sys kernel mode driver. It is available only on Windows. It is an alternative to Kestrel as well as to the IIS. It can be used, however, for intranet hostings or in situations where a feature is not available in Kestrel. You will have to refer to the MSDN documentation for finer details of the use of this utility. And in the next tutorial, we shall explore how to use launch settings file for running an ASP.NET Core application through Visual Studio. Thank you.